ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमः भगवते वासुदेवाय। नमः भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवते उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिके। रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद्भागवतम 10th कांटो चैप्टर 13 ब्रह्मा स्टीलिंग द बॉयज एंड कार्व्स टू द टेक्स्ट 62। दृष्ट्वा त्वरेण निज ध्वरणतो अवतीर्य पृथ्व्यां वपुः कनकदण्डं त्वाभिपात्यः स्पृष्ट्वा चतुर्मुकुटः कटिभिरङ्घ्रिजुग्मं नत्वा मदश्रुसज्जलै अकृताभिषेकम्। वर्ड मीनिंग दृष्ट्वा आफ्टर सीइंग त्वरेण विथ ग्रेट स्पीड हस्टली निज धोरणत फ्रॉम हिज स्वान कैरियर अवतीर्य डिसेंडेड पृथ्व्यां ऑन द ग्राउंड वपुः हिज बॉडी कनकदंड इव लाइक ए गोल्डन रॉड अभिपात्य फेल डाउन स्पृष्ट्वा टचिंग चतुर्मुकुट कोटिभि विद द टिप्स ऑफ हिज फोर क्राउन्स अंग्रिजुग्मम द टू लोटस फीट नत्वा मेकिंग ओबेसेंसेस मत अश्रु सुजलई विद द वाटर ऑफ हिज टीयर्स ऑफ जॉय अकृता परफॉर्म्ड अभिषेकम द सेरेमनी ऑफ बेदिंग हिज लोटस फीट। ट्रांसलेशन एंड पारपोर्ट बाय द डिसाइपल्स ऑफ हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस बाय प्रभुपाद 13 चैप्टर है। ओके पारपोर्ट बाय श्रील प्रभुपाद। ट्रांसलेशन After seeing this, Lord Brahma hastily got down from his swan career, fell down like a golden rod and tossed the lotus feet of Lord Krishna with the tips of his four crowns on his heads. Offering his obeisances, he bared the feet of Krishna with the water of his tears of joy. Please repeat. After seeing this, Lord Brahma hastily got down from his swan carrier, fell down like a golden rod, and tossed the lotus feet of Lord Krishna with the tips of the four crowns on his head. Offering his obeisances, he bathed the feet of Krishna with the water of his tears of joy. Purport. Lord Brahma bowed down like a stick, and because Lord Brahma's complexion is golden, he appeared to be like a golden stick lying down before Lord Krishna. When one falls down before a superior, just like a stick, one's offering of obeisances is called dandavat. Danda means stick, and vat means like. It is not that one should simply say dandavat, rather one must fall down. Thus Brahma fell down, touching his foreheads to the lotus feet of Krishna, and his crying in ecstasy is to be regarded as an abhishek, bathing ceremony of Krishna's lotus feet. He who appeared before Brahma as a human child was in fact the absolute truth. Parabrahman, Brahmeti Paramatmeti Bhagavaniti Sabdyate. The Supreme Lord is Narakriti, that is, he resembles a human being. It is not that he is four-armed Chaturbahu. Narayana is Chaturbahu, but Supreme Person resembles a human being. This is also confirmed in the Bible, where it is said that man was made in the image of God. Lord Brahma saw that Krishna in his form as a cowherd boy was Parabrahman, the root cause of everything, but was now appearing as a human child, loitering in Vrindavan with a morsel of food in his hand. Astonished, Lord Brahma hastily got down from his swan carrier and let his body fall to the earth. Usually the demigods never touch the ground, but Lord Brahma, voluntarily giving up his prestige as a demigod, bowed down on the ground before Krishna. Although Brahma has one head in each direction, he voluntarily brought all his heads to the ground and tossed Krishna's feet with the tips of his four helmets. Although his intelligence works in every direction, he surrendered everything before the boy Krishna. It is mentioned that Brahma washed the feet of Krishna with his tears, and here the word sajalahi indicates that his tears were purified. As soon as bhakti is present, everything is purified. Sarva upadhi vinirmuktam. Therefore, Brahma's crying was a form of bhakti anubhava, a transformation of transcendental ecstatic love. ओम अज्ञानातिमिरंधस्य ज्ञानंजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरुभे नमः श्रीचैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वंदे अहं श्रीगुरु श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरुं वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगण रघुनाथानितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजना सहितं कृष्णा चैतन्य देवं श्रीराधा कृष्ण पदान सहगण ललिता श्री विशाखानितांश्च नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी इति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे नमो महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामिने गौरतिशे नमः। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी विशभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। दृष्ट्वा त्वरेण निज धरणतो अवतीर्य पृथ्व्यां वपुः कनकदण्डम् इवाभिपात्य स्पृष्ट्वा चतुर्मुकुटकटिभिरङ्घ्रियुग्मं नत्वा मदश्रुसजलैरकृताभिषेकम्। आफ्टर सीइंग दिस लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा हास्टली गॉट डाउन फ्रॉम हिज स्वान कैरियर फेल डाउन लाइक ए गोल्डन रॉड एंड टॉस्ड द लोटस फीट ऑफ लॉर्ड कृष्णा विद द टिप्स ऑफ हर द फोर क्राउन्स ऑन हिज फोर हेड्स offering his obeisances, he bathed the feet of Krishna with the water of his tears of joy. So we are hearing this chapter from many speakers, and this is most controversial chapter also, because this Brahma Sampradaya Acharya Madhavacharya, he never commented this chapter. He did not write even a single word. In every chapter he just left like this verses. And that's why some of the other acharyas of this sampradaya, they even have doubt whether this chapter is part of Bhagavatam or not. Whether this chapter is Bhagavatam, part of Bhagavatam or not. Because it's very difficult to accept that our sampradaya acharya, he's the founder acharya of Brahma sampradaya. The sampradaya starting from him, Brahma. Brahma, Narada, Vyasa, Madan, Madhavacharya, like this. So, and but still, other acharyas, other sampradaya acharyas, they gave commentary and Srila Prabhupada gave commentary. So, we are discussing, and it is also this chapter, the last chapter that Prabhupada has commented, gave his Bhakti Vedanta purport, and few verses in next chapter, up to 13 or verse 30 or something, few chapter, few verses. Next chapter, Prabhupada gave purport then. So, this is, same time, this is also most important chapter. As Prabhupada's purport is there. And we see how Brahma, he heard about the killing of Aghasura. It is very difficult, even the demigods, they are very fearful of Aghasura, they can, not possible for them to kill him. But when Brahma heard this small boy, a four-year-old boy, he killed Aghasura, he came out and he saw that the soul of Aghasura was just going up, it was shining like anything. And he not waited in any other planets. He just crossed, even he crossed Brahmaloka, and he just go to enter to the Goloka. He got the Sarupya Mukti. Just so Brahma was astonished, what is going on? and she is such a great demon. Then he come to see, he come to this spot, in this planet, and come and saw that this boy, this Krishna, is sitting just surrounded by his cowherd boyfriends. They are sitting, and in the middle he was sitting, small boy. He was smiling, and he was talking friendly with his boyfriends, other boys of our boys, and they are carrying some curd rice in his hand and fruit salad. And even he did not know how to eat, eating sometimes right, sometimes left. And even other boys, they making him fool. One coward boy is telling, "Oh, Krishna, my mother made a special sweet today. I don't want to show you, but you just close your eyes and open your mouth, I'll put it inside." When Krishna closed eyes and put, then they put a flower inside. Then everyone clap, April Fool. So it's, how is it possible? Brahma is looking from his swan career, from up. Another coward boy is telling, after eating half of the laddu, he is telling, "This is very sweet, very tasty. Krishna, you take." After he giving his remnant to Krishna, Krishna is eating it. So in this way, Brahma is just observing what is going on. And this boy is the same Supreme Personality of Godhead, whom he has worshipped as Govindam Adi, Purusam Tamaham Bhajami. So Brahma now completely is in doubt, he bewildered. So that's why he wanted to test whether this boy is the same personality Krishna, or what is. So he, using his mystic power that is also given to him by Krishna, and comparing to Krishna's mystic power, this is very, very tiny, this is useless. Yesterday we have already discussed how he made Brahma bewildered more in Dwarka also. He saw so many Brahmas, four-headed Brahma, then 10-headed, 100-headed, and like this, millions of headed Brahmas. So this four-headed Brahma now, that was after. So he was thinking to test the mystic power of Krishna. So first he stole all the calves, first calves. Then when the coward boys were eating with Krishna, they are a little disturbed. Then they are just looking, "Where is calf?" Krishna told, "Don't worry, I am going, I will bring." Coward boys knows that if Krishna goes, definitely bring the calves. So then when Krishna went to search for the calves, then Brahma again stole all the coward boys. But I have heard that acharyas before class that he had no power, Brahma, to steal this Krishna's original associates, like Sridhama, Sudama, Subala, all these direct expansion from Krishna. They are not possible for Brahma to steal. So knowing Brahma's mind, Krishna already created another set of coward boys with his Yogamaya patterns. He just, this all original boys are not there. So anyhow, so Brahma, he fulfilled the desire of Brahma, that Brahma wanted to steal him and stole them. So now, as yesterday Vaishnava Maharaj was telling me how this, when Brahma stole these coward boys, the cubs, then even he, after that he went to his own abode and they refused. They are the chowkidars, the guards in Brahma Loka. There is another Brahma already sitting there. Krishna appointed another Brahma there. So he going there, they are refusing him to enter the planet. Because he is offended to Krishna. So anyhow, this is some place, some other, as I commented. So anyhow, so Brahma come back and he saw what is going on. Then he saw that this 1 year already passed for a moment in Brahma's calculation. But in the earth planet, the one years had already passed. And while Brahma saw that the same Krishna is sitting here and the same boys are surrounding him and same pastimes the eating prasadam is going on there. Still, you know, the laughing star, Krishna is there enjoying their feast. Brahma is telling how it happened. Maybe Krishna again brought them with his mystic power, from his yogic power. But he went there and saw that they are all sleeping, as before the boys are sleeping there. Then he come back and then he saw which is original, which is duplicate. He was just such a which one. So in this way, when Brahma was in just searching here and there, then Krishna just manifested. He saw them, that all these covered boys and calves, they are Vishnumurtis, 400 form. So then Brahma was completely bewildered. What is going on? He could understand. This small boy, he is not boy, he is the same person, the supreme personality of Godhead, Krishna himself. So that's why Brahma, after seeing this particular scene, that how Krishna is sitting, Krishna was sitting and all these covered, Krishna was there and all the covered boys and calves are manifested in Vishnumurti. Brahma could understand now the situation. So in this situation, when Brahma saw this, seeing this, after seeing Drishtva Tvarena, after seeing this scene, Brahma just with great speed, with hastily, Nija Dwaranataha from his swan career. He just jumped from his swan career, from back. Jumped from his swan career, Abhatirja descended. Where he descended on Prithibyam, on this earth planet, and just touching his bapu to the earth. Prabhupada commented that generally demigods, they not touch the earth planet, earth. They told it is dirty, this is impure, or like this. They remain on the sky. But here, Brahma, he break the regulatory principles. He just fell down in front of Krishna and he's touching the earth. Touching earth, fell down. And how he fell down? That is told on the ground, his body, kanaka dandam iba, like a golden rod. It's like golden rod is looking, because Prabhupada told that he's commenting that Brahma is looking like that molten gold, his body is like that, in that color. So when Brahma was dandavat, means just like we keep a stick, try to make it stand straight, then he just left it, then he will fall down immediately, straight. So dandavat, so Prabhupada is telling that dandavat, like stick, one offering of obeisance is called dandavat. So danda means stick, and vat means like. It is not that one should simply say dandavat. Rather, one must fall down when sometimes we see people say dandavat. But properly, if you are chant dandavat, then you must fall down. So Brahma fall down on the ground, and like a stick fell down on the ground, so the Brahma fell down. Kanaka danda eva, then abhipatya, and fell down. Then is sprishtva, touching his chaturmukuta kotibhi. Chaturmukuta, he has four head, so he has four helmets, sorry, mukuta. And koti means the top of the touching to the lotus feet of Krishna. How Brahma is forehead? Forehead is not in one direction, they are in different. First, front side, both side, and also in back side. So how he was putting this forehead in same and in front of, fell down in front of Krishna. Specifically, this head is there in back side. So this is also, I was seeing this one, as he commented this, he was actually rolling. Who? Brahma was first. This head, then this head, then this head, then this head, then he was just rolling again and touching this head to ground, again and the tip of the helmets. So in this way, Brahma was paying his dandavat pranam again and again to Krishna. He is paying his obeisances. And what that time, with the tips of four crowns, and where are the angri jugmam, the Krishna's angri, Krishna's feet, the 2 feet of Krishna, then he making natva again and again obeisances, and his eyes were madasru sujalai, with the water of his tears of joy. Brahma was very, he was not feeling something, others, but he was transcendentally joyful, because he is seeing this, the mystic power or yoga shakti of Krishna. He could understand, this is my master. He is everything for me. He is my father. He is my spiritual master, like, because he is the first, learned directly, he got knowledge from Krishna. So, he is everything. Janaka, Janani, Daita, Tanaya, Prabhu, Guru, Pati, Tuhu, Sarva, like Bhaktivinoda Thakur says. So, he is, could understand, he is my Supreme Lord, my Master. So, seeing this opulence of Krishna, he was in transcendental ecstasy. So, with his tears of joy, he performed Abhishekam, ceremony of bathing his lotus feet. Whose lotus feet? Krishna. He bathing the lotus feet of Krishna with his tears, his eyes. When Ganga just emanated from when Bali Maharaj was doing Abhishek, Bamana Dev, Bali Maharaj was doing Abhishek, then this Abhishek water, even Brahma collected in his commandolu, or when Ganga was just coming down, Brahma was keeping in his own commandolu. He could do Abhishek with his commandolu water, like Indra did the Abhishek. Indra did Abhishek of Krishna in that Govardhan Lila. Indra took the heavenly Ganges water through his elephant, Airavat, and he also took the milk of Surabhi cow, then did Abhishek. But Brahma is here, he doing like Abhishek with his tears from his eyes, just rolling again and again on the and in every side, this is from his eyes, the tear, the waters were transcendental waters, and that is from his tears of joy, they're just washing the feet of Krishna. And he is paying obeisances again and again, and did Abhishek, ceremony of bathing his lotus feet. So, but we can see who is more offender is Indra. Indra was also offended to Krishna. He was a great offender, or is Brahma is greater than him, or who is more offender? Offenses, whose offenses is more serious? Brahmaji's offense is more serious. Why? Because he disturbed Krishna in his pastimes. See, Krishna was with his devotees together. Krishna was sitting and all his devotees were with him. With the covered boys, and Krishna was playing and laughing and they had performed pastimes. But in Indra case, everyone was separated. All the Brajavasis were in their own places. And when Indra started this pouring, the heavy raining was there. So all ran to Krishna. All everyone come, and Krishna lifted the Govardhan Lila. They come inside, everyone. All the Brajavasis, all the gopis, all the gopas, everyone. Senior, junior, everyone there. Krishna was very happy by seeing all these Brajavasis, specifically the gopis, Radharani, and all the Kavad boys and Nanda, Yashoda, everyone was there. So he was not so angry with Indra. He told Indra, he did very nice job, because they all my devotees, they are now all, he make us all in together, 7 days and seven night together. So Krishna was not so much angry with Indra. He was Indra prayed and he came, and Indra was fearful, but Indra was very fearful. He was not even thinking to go directly to Krishna. He appointed a layer, who? Surabhi Kama. Surabhi Kama has to come on front and he has to walk in back. And Surabhi Kama has to tell Krishna that about Indra, to appeal Krishna, Krishna about Indra. That Indra was now repenting, he understood his offenses, like this. But Krishna was not angry. He accepted his abhishek, everything. Then he just gave a warning to Indra, you should not be popped up. Again, he asked him to going on doing his duties as king of heaven. But in Brahma case, when Brahma gave a nice prayer, such a hue, Brahma's prayer is very elaborate in next chapter. But after hearing the whole prayer, Krishna did not speak a single word. He was completely grave, standing, not spoke anything with him. Because he made separate the devotees from Krishna. So that's why Krishna was completely silent. After hearing all the prayers, such wonderful prayers in the next chapter, Brahma's prayers. He did not told in a single word. Krishna never spoke anything to Brahma. Standing here, there, as a usual man, standing, he did not know anything. Who is this four-headed man? Why is he paying obeisance? As if he did not know anything. So Brahma, that's why in the Brahma came as, in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu pastime says, Haridas Thakur. It's Brahma Haridas. The two Haridas, Brahma Haridas and Chota Haridas. So Brahma is Haridas Thakur, he was chanting every day 3 lakh names. Haristhane Aparadhe Tare Harinam. Then Krishna become pleased. Chaitanya, Lord Chaitanya, he is become so pleased. He lifted his dead body on his own hand and it's danced the kirtan. So that's why, so we see, so Haridas Thakur, when he appeared as Haridas Thakur, then he saw the how to please Krishna. You must, specifically in this age of Kali, you must take shelter of holy name of the Lord. Harer Nama Iva Kevalam Kalo Nasteiva Gatiranyata. The whole purpose of reading Bhagavatam also, same. Kalo Dosa Nidhe Rajan Astihi Eka Mahan Guna Kirtana Deva Krishnasya Mukta Sangha Parangrajet. This Kali Yuga has the ocean of the false mistakes. There are no good qualities, but there is one good quality. Kirtanat Eva Krishnasya. Only this good quality, if one accepts, then he will be delivered from the cycle of birth and death. Even the concluding, there are so many verses in Bhagavatam, he's telling about this. This is the essence. Even the concluding verse, Sut Goswami told, Nama Sankirtanajasya Sarva Bhava Pranasanam. If you want to, one become sinless, then as Krishna told Sarva Dharman Paritejya, Mam Ekan Saranam Braja. Just give up everything and surrender unto me. How he surrendered? This is the way. But chant Hare Krishna, be happy. So that's why this is Sarva Papa Pranasanam, Pranama Dukkha Samanam. by simply paying obeisances to the Supreme Lord, one become free from the all types of fears, and fear of Jamaraj. He will free from all types. That's why Brahma is paying here obeisances, full dandavat. Before, if you want to surrender someone, you must pay full dandavat pranam. Then, that is, Prabhupada is telling, if you want, telling this dandavat, just, he must pay obeisances. So, Brahma, as an acharya, he taught us everything by his personal example. And so we have to follow the, Brahma showed us how to surrender to Krishna. And he himself appeared as Haridas Thakur in this age of Kali and taught the way. Harinama Chintamani, wonderful pustak. The wonderful book, that is Bhaktivinoda Thakur's commentary with this. And taught, if you want to surrender to Krishna in this way, Krishna is telling you, surrender unto me. How to surrender? Then you simply take shelter of holy name and go on chanting. Kali Kale Nama Rupe Krishna Avatar. In this age of Kali, Krishna appeared as holy name of the Lord. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So 5 minutes, that is about 5 minutes. So any question or comment?
If chanting is the goal of everything, why do we do other things?
Because you cannot do this other thing. We cannot chant 24 hours like Haridas Thakur. That's the Prabhupada told. Actually, this is a real business, to chant day and night. But because of our own nature, we cannot do this. That's why different engagements there. Cannot do like, no one is can imitate Haridas Thakur. Can chant 3 lakh every day. Not 3 lakh actually, he chant 1 crore in 1 month. That means not 3 lakh, more than 3 lakh. 3 lakh it will be 90 lakh, but he is 100 lakh who is chanting. So no one can imitate. So that's why you cannot try to imitate, you have to follow the instructions that is coming through acharyas. Coming through Prabhupada, not told past to chant 16 round. 64, not possible. 32, after 1 week they come back, no, it is also not possible. The Prabhupada told this is 16 round must, no reduction. Then he, according to nature, we have to engage in some physical activities, to do some service. Krishna told in Bhakti Yoga first, mayeva mana adhosya mayi buddhiṃ niveśaya. Niveśi śeṣi mayeva ato uddhaṃ nasaṃsaya. You have to if you are not able to do this, then abhyasa yogena mamichyaptum dhananjaya. Try to practice. Even if you are not able to practice the devotional, the regulative principles and this according to the acharyas, and if you not practice the bhakti yoga with this, then mat karma parama bhava. Then you have to work for me.
It said also that by reciting Srimad Bhagavatam and attending classes, the same as chanting, that that's also kirtan.
Yes. Srimad Bhagavatam is also chanting of Srimad Bhagavatam and chanting of holy name is the same. That's why the acharya for Sravana Kirtanam is Sukadeva Goswami and Parikshit Maharaj. They're chanting and hearing Bhagavatam.
Hare Krishna. Thank you very much. Maharaj, let us say somebody says, I cannot chant the whole day today. But in future, I will. In future, I can.
Future?
In future, I will do 24 hours, 190 kilometers, but in future, I can chant 192 kilometers.
Keep mic little distance.
Listen.
Your sound is not clear.
Like in future, somebody says, I cannot do now 192 kilometers. Let us say 3 lakhs. But in future, I will do.
Then he has to eat also future. Suspend his eating. I not eat today, I mean eat after. When I chant, then I will eat. As you like.
It's like a few choice.
Yes. Actually. Yes. Already answer is giving by Pachavala. So
somebody can do like this.
No. Why you look at this is a laziness, eh? Prabhupada told this can is for everyone but not for the two people. Lazy and crazy. If it was lazy, then how can I always, future never, the present is the most important. Calm, future never come, tomorrow never come. Every day will go on tomorrow then.
So, why somebody cannot come to the world?
I cannot understand this. What is
why somebody cannot come
to the world? Why cannot chant? You chant fast, you practice. You show an example. You show fast example that chanting 192. Can you run? So, why cannot chant? Because the mode of nature. Everyone is in different mode. You have to come above the modes. Above the modes. Three modes. Manave, manopamanaya tulya, tulya mitra arivakheva, sarvarambha guna, sarvarambha parityagi gunatita saucchetalekhi. Krishna told the symptoms of a person who is above the three modes of material nature. When one comes above the three modes, then he will think about chanting all the time. Because we are influenced by the material modes. So we have to act accordingly. It is not so easy. So any other question?
Hare Krishna Maharaj.
Tell, now you are seeing the Prabhupada told. Many people they ask, just repeat Dandavat. Don't tell Dandavat, just speak.
Hare Krishna Maharaj. My question is, as you talk about Lord Brahma as forehead, so what the forehead signify here? What the four heads of Brahma signify?
What the four heads of Brahma?
Signify, what it means? What the meaning of that four heads?
What signifies his forehead? I don't know. You see, everywhere, all side is
pure.
So many. There are many Brahmas, they have different head, they have. But this particular Brahma of this universe has four head.
You talked about it, some Brahmas have 100 heads also.
Thousands, yes.
This was, that was powerful. If I have four
head. I don't know, you have to ask Krishna directly. Maharaj want to comment.
Because our universe is the smallest.
Yes. Smallest is four.
Yeah. So only you need four heads still to manage our universe. Other universes are much bigger. So they need 100 heads or 1,000 heads.
Okay.
So our diameter of our universe is 4 billion miles in diameter. Okay, so you need four heads. Other is bigger, so you need four heads.
So, any other question? Any comment? Okay, no other question, comment, so we stop here. Srila Prabhupada ki.